that 29% of voters said that neither Hillary nor Trump was honest or trustworthy. And of that group, they said all of the dice were Trump. And I think there was just too much experience
with Clinton and corruption and lying. Donald Trump's like, I've only disliked him for 18 months. But Hillary Clinton only had a couple of decades. She needs that turnout. She isn't going to have any chance of winning this race.
You talk about this, what appears to be maybe unsatisfactory turnout from the point of view of the Clinton team.
I'll tell you a story. I was up here on Monday, the final day of early voting, and I talked to quite a few voters, including a number of African-American voters, and I was asking them about their motivation, about whether their friends and family were turning out. And the sense I got of it, and this was not a statistically valid sample, but the sense I got from the people I spoke with, the African American voters there, was that they were voting mostly out of a sense of duty, obligation, almost habit. I did not hear from one single person anything that could fairly be categorized as
You want Congress to address the problem of democracy. So it's not that this is the most important issue. It's not those issues are the most important issue. This is just the first issue.
This is part of a very clear strategy. The concept that can help us understand it is probably that of the overtone window, which refers to the window of acceptability in public debate. What can be said without sounding extremist or outlandish? And what Salvini is doing is condoning overtly racist statements, minimizing racial attacks in the country. In order to pass his own government policy based on institutional racism as something acceptable, moderate even, compared to the kind of racial attacks we see on the street. The reason for this is rather simple. Salvini needs countries that accept and institutionalize racism because he needs somebody to scapegoat. This government is not going to be able to do anything to the economic life of Italians.
Some of the shocking profanity and threats of violence you're about to hear are actual quotes from figures elected in this house.
Oh,